Alright, I guess even bosses that I think I'm familiar with, I'm not quite familiar with. Sucks to be new. Alright, I swear. Well, we have some new people at least, so that's nice. Let's try out the Marine again. We'll swap back and forth through characters. Ooh. He'll sell me stuff now. Since our little business arrangement has been turning a profit, I thought I might expand my inventory a bit. Let me know what you need, and I'll get it added to my stock. Thank you, dude. So now I have multiple characters to spend my credits with, and I still don't know what these two do, but whatever. Allegedly, they respawn. One day, box. One day. And we go. With the Marine. Sorry that I have decreased in quality since your arrival, Tranger. I was doing pretty good earlier. He says as getting hit in the first room. Alright, I didn't need the helmet. The helmet was weighing me down. Granted, the Marine has probably been my worst character thus far. Whether the Marine is a bad character or not remains to be seen. In fact, I'm pretty sure most people love the Marine. I've just been having bad luck with him. That's a lot of books. NR. It's a good thing they didn't put a T in there. Do something dangerous. Alright, that was almost cool. Kinda like what Winchester said. That's crazy though how we got such a good item for failing. Imagine if we would have succeeded. Lodestone ammolet. Nice pun. Keep going. Good, alright. Nice key. Who's a good key? Alright. That's kinda lame. I'm probably not gonna get any use of that pepper. It's area damage around me. I'm not even sure how much damage it is, but you never want to be close to enemies. Keep going. See you guys, the helmet was holding me back the whole time. What is over here? That's a fairy in a jar. Yes, yes, you seem to be fine. Unfortunate. You're perfectly healthy, are you sure? I guess they heal you to full or something. That's neat. Always finding new rooms in this game. A lot left to be discovered for sure. I've been playing too many freaking strategy games, man. Action games are kinda kicking my ass right now. Okay. I don't know how true it is, but like, in Binding of Isaac, I know that the game is kind of designed in a way where people who aren't very good at the game can still win if they get lucky with items and whatnot. And I'm not exactly sure how much Gungeon has in that regard. Because I feel like you need a certain amount of skill in order to play this game, whether you inherently have it or you acquire it through gameplay. Remains to be seen. Ah, brown chest, come on now. But, yeah. I don't know, it's just that in Isaac, you can just dodge around. Of course, you might not be used to it, and there's also, like, enemy recognition and whatnot. But it's not as bullet-helly until later parts of the game, so it's, like, reasonable. Whereas with this, you could be on the first floor and you can get some pretty crazy room layouts. And that's not even discussing what comes later, right? Well, if I get my ass kicked to the boss, I have full health waiting for me, allegedly. I don't know, maybe at some point in time there'll be some kind of built-in mechanic that I gain purely based off playing the game alone that gives me some kind of an edge. There's our boss. I mean, I shouldn't open it, but I'm going to. You never know. I'm actually gonna shoot it once in case it's a mimic. Regular shotgun. Oh no, it's the sawed-off. That's even worse. I would have much rather the regular shotgun. Alright, well, screw the regular shotgun. We're switching to our marine sidearm and we're gonna fight this boss. Which is the Trigger Twins. Just keep rolling, rolling, rolling. Is definitely not the wrong idea, for sure. Definitely for sure. You heard it here, folks. You heard it here first, folks. Spawn some ads somewhere. Come on. Alright, we killed one, which I don't think is actually a good thing. That guy's body has a hitbox.
Yes! Did you die again? Yeah, I died again, but this time we aced the boss!
Easy. Oh god. Fight Saber. HP upgrade and some armor.
Fight Saber. Reload to reflect nearby bullets. That sounds awesome. An ancient weapon composed entirely of hardened light.
I believe that this fight saber is like a really, really OP weapon, so the game has blessed me today, for sure, but I'm gonna stick to this marine sidearm for now. I should probably do a couple shots with this though, just to try it out, and plus if I'm using this as my primary weapon, every armor drop helps. Let's see how much damage it does though. I've seen one person use this, and it looked really good. And plus, reflecting bullets by reloading sounds awesome. That guy's pretty red. That's so cool. So, if you have too many good items, or if you do some shady stuff, those, I think they're called jammed enemies show up, and those dark red bullets actually do full heart of damage, not just half a heart of damage. I like that gun. I'm glad you like it. I think I legit might buy this game. Alright, sounds good, man. What kind of tomfoolery is this? This is a big room. Down? Not down. This way? Okay, it's over there. Gotcha. This is a gun that transforms into a lightsaber when you reload. I can't spell, I swear. It's all good, stranger. Sometimes none of us can spell. That room is bollocks. Oh my god, it's a freaking jammed up night. I think what happened is this gun is supposed to spawn much later in the game. So because they gave it to me so early, they're spawning a bunch of... Or because it spawns so early, it's cursed. And spawning a bunch of these assholes. So I can probably strategically reload to reflect bullets. And I tried it there, and that was freaking stylish. Alright, I love this gun. Alright, keep going. Oh my god, it's so good! Give me the ammo! I never want to stop using this. Nice loop around there. Oh, there's a cell key here. Oopsie. Is this only single player? There's local co-op, but there's no online co-op, unfortunately. So if I grabbed my second controller, or if I had another person, they could come play with me as well. But unfortunately, there's no online. I don't know what the developers said about whether they're including it later or not, but that's all I know. It's safe over here. Alright, down we go. This fight saber, though, is so sweet. It's so good! This thing's gonna save me from quite a couple rooms. Local, so some computers, or you can LAN. Same computer, but if it's local, I imagine you can probably LAN if you use something like Hamachi or Garena or something along those lines. However, the game just came out today, so I don't know if anybody has those kind of things set up just yet. It's so good! I just want to reload people's bullets back at them all the time. Oh my god. Alright, this is my new favorite gun of the ones I've seen so far. Oh my god, it's so clutch. This thing is gonna save me so much. It already is. I'm not even dodge rolling anymore. I've just been relying on the reload. Alright. Probably should deal with these trash enemies with my marine sidearm, though. Even though ammo drops have been kind of generous, you don't want to be left out in the cold. But we have a cell key, so we'll unlock some more progress, hopefully. A regular generic chest, no thank you. Not for now, right? Let me open up this passageway, though. So I can teleport back and get it. You gotta go through a big room. This way. Shrine? I believe if I drop my gun here, he heals me. He can't have it. I could drop the sawed off of there, though. But I don't need it right now. I'd like to get this prime primer. We'll see. If I get the money for it. kind of too slow there. The bullets, that is. Snaps the Blook. There goes Naps the Blook. I wonder if the does melee damage as well. I'm not cocky enough to test that out just yet. Ah, I got hit. I was trying to be cocky enough to test it out. I'm pretty sure that does melee damage. Actually, no, I have the pepper. That's what's causing it. Alright, I'm an idiot. I took a bunch of damage for no reason. It's all good. Ooh, also we have the airdrop, so even if we are running low on ammo, I'm good to go. Lightsaber. There's a dude over here. Some sort. Oh, it's the minigame guy again. Neat. Yes, please. Unfortunately, I can't get the prime primer in all likelihood now, but oh well. What happens if I shoot that block? Does it break? Oh, it doesn't bounce my shot. That's... okay, that one breaks. Ah. Oh well. Had I known that earlier. But for next time. Wow, that was almost cool. You can have this. Thank you, good sir. Ah, stupid orange. I still don't know what it does. I should really use it sometime. Alright, let's use the drop. And then we'll pick up the orange. And I will use it, I promise. I don't know who I promise, but I promise someone. We can go in here. Ooh, okay. There's a vampire lady brushing her hair. Quite jealous. Happy waifu, happy laifu. You freed me. Why? That's always a good sign. Well. See you around sometime, I guess. And the altar. I'd take her to the altar, if you know what I mean. Chest I can't open. It would be cool to have a vampire wife. It definitely would be. Fight saber. Alright, keep going. Here's our boss fight, finally. So there's two chests on this level still. I don't remember what color that one was. And we can't afford the prime primer anymore, so I could buy a key and open one of them. What color were you? I think this was the brown one, so I'm probably gonna ignore it. Yes. So we'll go over here, where the nice lady was. But I'm glad that you're on Team Vampire Wife Tranger. Where's the chest? Oh, idiot. It's up here. I went back to the cage. Alright. Ooh, the stinger. I've actually seen this one before. It's really cool. Originally used to swat down bothersome aircrafts, the stinger has become a favorite of the aim-deficient Gungeoneer. Alright, you're gonna love this one. It's quite the amusing weapon for sure. Hey, it's the bee holster. He can bee-holst these bees. I got hit there. I'm the worst. Go, orange! I don't know what that did. But essentially, this stinger here actually shoots bees. So I just realized I'm subbed to 4 MMOs I don't even play. Damn, that's probably sapping your funds quite a little bit. You should probably unsub to those. Hey, we unlocked this earlier, and now we can use it. Iron coin. Valor Morgwins. Also, the orange is gone. Well, that's a bummer. Alright. Payment for services rendered. This mysterious coin vanished when tossed into the air. Well, it has three uses. That's really odd. I can open up that chest that we left behind. I'm gonna do it, even though I shouldn't. Why do you got the sub button yet? I don't know, Tranger. Maybe one day, man. That thing looks cursed as hell. You see that black aura and the fact that it's jumping? I ain't about that. We ain't doing this. let's go over here. Not popular, man, unfortunately. But hey, I do this out of love. I think that's it. Yeah, down we go. Grab some tea. So, you're all about the vampire wife, but not cursed shields. Yep! What can I say? He's the- ooh, nice sneaky ghost there. I didn't even realize you were in the room with me. This is the Gungeon. We don't need cursed shields in the Gungeon. I'm gonna try to kill this guy with DOT, and it's gonna be stupid, but we can test how good that is. And it's not very good. I'm really liking this stinger, though. It's very good for easily clearing rooms. I don't know how good it is for bosses. Alright, that's a jammed enemy. Mr. Jammerino there went into the pit. The drink, if you will. What are these? So many new things. A whole new world. God only knows. I didn't sing it right. I sang one song and then it turned into another song. Also, I have this shot-off shotgun for some reason still. And that's a skull. That's a skull. That's a skull. That's a skull. Okay, it's no longer a skull. But we can reflect it. Alright. Oh, come on, a triggered one? Oh, that was stylish. One more, come on. Yeah! Alright, thanks for the blank. Also, thanks for the memories, even though they weren't so great. Oh, that didn't kill him. Also, I'm on fire. Those jammed enemies are quite troublesome. However, considering I can reflect their bullets back, and the reflected bullets seem to do good damage, that's nice. Up here. Oh. Ah, blank's really late. I'm taking a lot of stupid damage, not knowing what's going on and shooting my missiles off. But I also blame new enemy types that I have no idea what they do. Like this mushroom. Who leaves a bunch of bullets up behind. And this mushroom, which is a jerk. And these mushrooms. There's a lot of mushrooms. Not enough bees. Alright, there's our shopkeep. We can buy some health there. But realistically though, if you had to choose, Stranger, Cursed Shield or Vampire Wife? I think the question answers itself. is the bubble bobble guy. I definitely would welcome that shrine that transfers guns into health at this point. That's a Tommy gun. Take that. If we need it, we'll come back for the ammo for our fight saber. I should also... Ooh. Hey, it's Lock Dude. The locks in this place are all sentient. A ballot cost... Ooh, everything costs keys. Ring of Mimic Friendship. Ring of Chest Vampirism. So I have no idea what the ballot does, and I have no idea what this does. I'm assuming it just makes mimics passive. But if I get this, every time I break a chest, it'll heal me by one heart, half heart. Which is actually really good. Especially if I don't have the keys in the future. Which I don't have at the moment, but it costs a key to get it. And I still don't know what this spacebar item does, and I wish I could use it to purchase something. Hmm. What if the vampire wife were to present to you with a cursed shield? Would you take it then, or horribly offend her by rejecting her gift? I, as someone who doesn't really like gifts, but I will accept any gift given to me. Because it would be rude not to take it. However, if the choice occurred, I would definitely pick A over the latter. Got in the minecart, and I slapped him with my lightsaber. Alright, this game, 10 out of 10. Thank you for the ammo. I could get it for the stinger, but I won't. Because this fight saber is definitely doing... What about the gift of death? I would graciously accept it one of these days. Plus, have you seen Mistress Death? If she wasn't all that, Deadpool wouldn't be fighting for her all the time. Or Thanos. Any more enemies here? Nope. Still have no idea what this coin does. Also, another chest. I really want that Ring of Vampirism to heal myself. Seems like it would be useful. Blue chests are usually passive, though. Eh. But I guess the ring in and of itself is passive, so whatever. Shoot it. Shoot it. Ah, oh, don't shoot it. And that's why I watch you comic nerd come out. Yep. Ooh, okay. I tried to press the dodge roll button, but I pressed the blank one. I think the blank was definitely the preferred one. I'm actually not that big of a comic book nerd, but I enjoy what I've read. But then again, I read a lot of manga, and mangas are just Japanese comics, so I guess I'm technically a comic nerd no matter where I look. Aw, sick reflection. Wonderful. Almost as good as Mama. Hey, half a heart. Or a full heart. And a Valor Morgunus. Okay. I appreciate the heart, though. Fight Saber. Fight Saber. The Fight Saber is, if anything other than carrying my run, the Fight Saber has taught me how to reload properly. And for that, I thank it greatly. Ah, oh, yes, thank you. For blessing me. Oh, I want a key so bad. Please, shopkeep, do you have one? I bought it already and I opened something useless. It feels bad, man.
Alright. No, well. Actually, I don't read a lot of comics either, which people don't believe. I just read about a cool character I like, and then he linked to some other characters that I read who are linked to other characters, and so I go on these rabbit holes and come out knowing a lot about comics without reading comics. That's exactly the same thing that happens to me, Tranger. I get interested in one character via some kind of means, and then I dig into like one or two comics about them, and then I look up a bunch of facts because I get interested. But then I don't really delve super deep down the rabbit hole, but the parts that I do delve into, I'm quite happy with. But so I guess we'll fight the boss, we'll kill the boss, hopefully, and then we'll get this chest. And then I guess I'll explode the other ones. If we get two keys, salty run back time. Cannon Balrog, we meet again. Last time I didn't really get to learn what you do. Hopefully this time I do better. Got me last time. I didn't flawless him, but whatever. He's gonna do this again. Gun OP. Tell me about it. Alright. I rolled into him. Alright. That's so cool. I love it. You shoot a couple shots, you reflect a couple bullets. This gun can be really broken if you know what you're doing. Here's the dangerous part. You gotta roll into the bullets. Yeah! Cannon Balrog! We did it! Oh, I don't see a key. Ooh, that's the shield breaker we saw before. Betrayer shield gun, actually a gun. Betrayer shield, actually a gun. Let's take a look at this. Generates a protective shield upon reloading. Guess the game wants me to be pretty defensive. Blockner lost his knighthood when he betrayed Sir Manuel, but he did not lose his gun. He did that much later. That's... meh. I wish I had one key. I shouldn't have spent it, but how do you know, right? See, the thing is, if I had the mimic thing, or the vampire ring, I'd be okay. But I guess now we'll just have to shoot the chest, because we have no choice, because the game was not kind enough to give me an item. Or a key from the boss. And we got junk out of the super awesome mega chest. And we'll go over here, see if we get anything from this other chest. Such a bummer. And if we had the vampirism ring, we would have healed for one full heart doing this as well as the chance of getting loot. So all things are very sad, and we didn't get anything at all. So moral of the story is, hold on to your keys, because things may come that are much better. And I guess we'll go buy ammo. Yep. Definitely need to have this fight saber ready at all times. This thing will carry me with its awesomeness. And this is the first time we're going to floor 4. Get hype. I believe this is floor. Floor. Such a cute loading screen. 10 out of 10.
Yes, the Hollows, Chamber 4. There's Skellamon.
Don't be sad, Sin. Now you can start an awesome junk collection. Sounds good. Laggy kitten! Long time no see. How are you doing?
But yes, I can start an awesome junk collection. At least I still have my fight saber. Now I know how, whatchamacallit, fighting game guys feel without their fight sticks. This is exactly the feeling I imagine. Oh, thank you so much, game. Ooh, there's, like, traps in the wall now. But how are you doing, Laggy? I've missed having you around.
Yo, Sin, how are you? Let's go, Blanco! Long time no see as well, good friend.
How you doing? I am just enjoying Enter the Gungeon. How are you? And I'm having fun with this fight saber. Definitely the favorite weapon of that I've had. Oh, it's so stylish. Melee him! Alright, shouldn't get too carried away, but I'm really, really enjoying this one. Ooh, that's a sweet-ass door. And also something crazy is shooting over there.
Just passing out, but what the hell is that game?
This is Enter the Gungeon! A crazy bullet hell roguelike game in the same vein as A Binding of Isaac or A Nuclear Throne. It's very, very heavily gun-based. And everything is a gun pun. And it's really fun. And it came out today. That's a new enemy. He has a gun shotgun scythe. What? Did he die? Seems like he died.
Do you have a favorite starting character, Sin?
So far, I'm really enjoying the pilot. Which is weird. Because I think a lot of people don't like the pilot, but the pilot seems to be to get a lot of like really good luck. It's like his drop rate is high, which is nice. Let's go over here. But this marine run is the best run I've had so far. But that doesn't make marine my favorite character. This guy, ooh, he's a necromancer. That's cool. Mm-hmm. Stay away. Thank you. Any more enemies? No? Good, good. Fight saber's running low on ammo. Very, very afraid. I have triangle shot PTSD after fighting all those lead maidens. Oh, we can reflect those back as well. I have no idea what half the enemies that are spawning are and what do they do. Nice. Ooh, spooky skeleton! What is that? What is this? Who are you?
Did it despawn?
It did despawn. Can I shoot its head? Oh, I do have to shoot its head. Or else it respawns, apparently. This game gets crazy. Low on ammo. Starting to get worried. Still have no idea what this coin does. Ammo drops. Greatly appreciated. I should probably rely on reflecting bullets a bit more. Ah, derp. Can't reload a gun that's full on ammo. Thank you for the half heart. And we'll go up. Still don't have a key to open the big red chest with. Unfortunate. But we will roll, and we will roll to victory. How about you, kitten? What's your favorite character? Need to kill the necromancer. That is a cool shot, and I'm afraid of it. Alright, you are deceased. You need to die. Where's the head? Oh, it didn't spawn a big skeleton. I guess he has to take the time to summon one. Ooh, still tight on ammo. If I throw this last coin, will something good happen? I don't know. Off. Shoot me. And then shoot yourself. Alright, gotta be careful now. My favorite gun's about to run out. There's still no ammo drops anywhere. Alright, well, he switched to Blockner's gun. The damage doesn't seem bad on Blockner's gun, actually. I should probably just chill out and use this for a little bit. I'm gonna miss the fight saber, though. 16 bullets. I haven't really found a favorite myself, but I seem to play my best as Hunter. Free keys and the crossbow hold up pretty well in 3-4. Sounds good. Ouchie. The Hunter's definitely up there. I think a Hunter is my second favorite character. I really enjoy the crossbow she starts with as well. This is super easy. Oh, okay. I didn't see the slime that spawned behind me. It spawned from behind. Yeah, Lochner's gun is pretty decent for what it does. And I have no idea where the shop is. And I wish to find it. And this guy needs to die before he buffs any dudes. So bad I haven't flawless a single boss though. It's okay. Laggy. We'll all get there. It's the first day. I can only floss. I'm really inconsistent. I can flawless bosses, but then I get like overconfident and then I fail to flawless them the second time. And we still have no keys. Not like I would open that yet anyway. And I'm still haven't found an ammo drop, which is a bummer because the fight saber, I miss it dearly. And my HP is rather low. Okay. Thanks for spawning behind me. Now I'm at half a heart. How things turn. That genie needs to go. Okay. Close one. That shield lasts quite a while. That's neat. If only I had one ammo drop this whole floor. Damn. Alright, that's unfortunate. But that was a good run. That was the best I've done for a while now. Lore Gungeoner, or Gungeoner. So he's like a conjurer for guns? Oh well. It was such a good run, too. Yeah. We had, like, key bereftness, though. I think a couple more keys and we could have pulled it off. Wahahaha. Teleporting bullets. The dream. So, let's...